Today is Monday, February 1st. I'm exhausted. I don't even feel like doing vlogs anymore. And I'm just kind of having a tough time, but before I felt this way this morning, I decided to tell my friend Angela that we would do a fitness and health weight loss challenge kind of thing together. I think I kind of put my foot in my mouth, but I guess I should do it anyways. So I'm gonna weigh myself and go from there, I guess.
Probably the largest I've ever been. So, 1 pound difference. But yeah, I'm 242.8. Without the camera, and I have clothes on, I weighed 242.8. I'm starting my breakfast at 10 to 10, because I just basically finished feeding Honesty. And so, and Honesty's my daughter, in case you don't know, that's my little cutie right there. I'm having half a banana to start out with. So I'm starting to cook my breakfast, and I'm having like a teaspoon or two of butter in the pan, and then I've got one full large egg and probably about, I don't know, maybe half a cup or so of egg whites, these ones here. I am so cranky. Like, I let my friend go off Facebook last night. I was exhausted at like 1 something, but I was already really exhausted, and I was like, I gotta get downstairs. Next thing I know, I fell asleep on the couch. That's my thing. I tend to fall asleep on the couch because I eat a bunch of junk or something, or I'm just exhausted. So I gotta get back into a good sleeping pattern and get my vlogs up to date. For breakfast, I'm having this omelet with a little bit of cheese. There's probably about less than a fourth of a cup of cheese in there, a few tablespoons. Then I'm going to have some Carthine's organic raw unpasteurized sauerkraut and 2 yogurt, and plus the half a banana. My key here is, you know, not starving myself, but also making sure I'm making healthy choices.
It's 12 o'clock. Today was a half and half day. My day started out with me being extremely tired and lethargic and wanting to just stay in bed all day, but obviously I couldn't do that. I have Honesty. So she woke up right before 9 o'clock, and I got her food ready. She was eating by 9:30. She had some rice puffs and Nutrios with a little bit of milk and some yogurt and some crushed raspberries, and she was good with that. And then she had half a banana and some water to drink. Honesty played, we watched some cartoons, then I played with her, then I got her lunch ready. And for her lunch, she had some curry soup that was supposed to be a leek soup, but we couldn't get leeks because there was none at the grocery store. Anyway, Matt made it, and I froze a bit of it for Honesty so that she'd have some. And then I put some extra sweet potato in it, and I also put some chicken in it, and so she ate that for lunch. And for my lunch, I had honey garlic chicken and vegetables, and then I had some ice cream. Honesty napped. She napped almost up until Matt got home, spare a few minutes, so she just sat in the crib. But where things went downhill for me was this morning when I was getting on that scale. As you guys saw, I wasn't ready. I'm not ready to do a weight loss challenge, and I had to be honest with myself. I was trying to do this for my friend and for myself, obviously, but I don't know. I just feel like I'm gonna be destined to be fat for the rest of my life or something, because I can't seem to get a hold of this. And no matter how many times I try, I just want to go back to eating all that comfort food. So I think I need to deal with my mental health issues and take this journey slowly and not do this journey for anybody else, but for me. And the next time somebody asks me to do it with them, I need to pipe up and say no, because as much as I don't want to be selfish and I want to help other people and I want to do collaborations on YouTube, a weight loss thing is just not a collaboration I'm looking for at this time. I was already upset about that. And then I had to write her and tell her that, you know, I couldn't do it, which broke my heart. I thought I wanted to do it last night. Like, I had convinced myself completely yesterday. And I was 100% sure. I was like, oh yeah, I'm going to do this. Oh, I'm so excited. And we have plans and everything. But I can't let her down later in the game. I'd rather just tell her now. I am still eating somewhat good, but I just don't want the pressure to eat, you know, perfect and then work out perfectly because people are watching me. I don't want to disappoint, and I would rather just do this for me anyways right now. If I get into the groove and I see that things are going well, then you guys are already going to see the struggle of me getting there because I vlog daily. Facebook is just pissing me off. People are so fucking rude. Excuse the swearing there. But they are, to the point where they're like, oh, if you're going to be negative or you're going to be this or that, like, or if you're going to complain about your friends or your husband or this person or that person, you shouldn't be doing it online. It's like, who are these people to say what people should do online? You want to censor people who need some sort of outlet? Like, are you kidding me? Oh, well, I would never publicly embarrass my wife or my husband, one of them says, and I'm just like, oh, okay, well, you may not suffer from depression, and you may not have a wife or husband that sometimes when you tell them how you feel, says they don't want to hear it. And I've had friends like that, and when they don't want to hear it, I have to vent. Sure, then your next thing is, why don't you vent to your real friends and family? Because they're always partial to me, or usually. So I go on to get some perspective. And it's not that I want opposition, but sometimes I need it. It kind of just helps put things in perspective for me. And sometimes it's good when people can empathize with me, because maybe, you know, whoever I'm having a fight with doesn't empathize with me, and I need that. And it's just different for people who are vocal and who have depression. There are people who have depression, but they keep it all in. I'm not one of those people, and I don't intend to ever be one of those people. But anyway, I just kept seeing a bunch of those statuses, and I said, screw it. I'm going off of Facebook for a while, because these people are just too much. They're too much. And the funny thing is that one person's like, oh, I can't stand all the negativity. These people are so negative. Like, get off, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, you're being negative about people who are negative. You're just like us. Like, and I don't want to be negative, and I don't want to not be successful. I want to be successful, and I want to be positive, because I have been, and it felt amazing, but I don't know how to get there again. I am stuck, and I am on a waiting list to see a psychologist or a psychiatrist, but this isn't going to be an easy journey. So these people just telling people to shut up and keep it in, it's like, who are you to say that? You're just as bad as people who are bullying others or fat shaming people. Oh, you're so fat, you should lose weight. Oh, you're so vocal about your problems in your life, you should shut up about those so that you can get really upset and sad and take it out on yourself by ridding yourself of being on this planet. Like, that just bothers me. Like, we're supposed to be here for one another, not be against each other. And ooh, okay, done. Anyway, so I was already really upset. So I deactivated Facebook today. And anyway, so I was feeding Honesty her lunch, and she was just playing with it. Like, she was just playing with it, and it frustrated me. Like, she'd take the spoon, put it in, and then go like this with the spoon, like, shake it or whatever. And then it would go all over the place. And I'm okay with her being, you know, like, just experimenting and getting good at this. But when you've got so many other things to do, and you're already stressed out and tired, you don't want to be cleaning all day. So anyway, I take the bowl and the spoon away from her. Doesn't she start screaming and crying, which makes me feel even worse. So I'm staying calm all the while, mind you. And I'm saying, honesty, stop, use your spoon, eat, put it in your mouth. I point to my mouth, point to her mouth, and she just keeps doing it because I gave it back to her. So I took it away again, freaked out. And then I was feeling tears welling up in my eyes. And so I was like, you know what? I can't watch her make a mess, but if that's what she wants to do, I am going to go cry in the bathroom. So I went into the bathroom and I cried. And I cried for probably about 5 minutes. There was no choking hazard, so don't worry. Everything was really soft and chewy and whatever. So anyway, I came out and I wiped my eyes and I felt a lot better, mind you, but I was still just stressed, super stressed. So anyways, when she was done lunch, I put her down for a nap, and then she had mango for snack, or for dessert, and for snack, she had cheese and some puffs, some broccoli and spinach puffs. So anyway, she was down for her nap, and like, I told Matt how bad of a day I had, and he said, you know what, just wait until I get home, I'll go get her. So we went and got her, and I just stayed on the couch, like, staring at my computer and reading an article for, like, I don't know, like, 10 minutes or something. And then, because she woke up, and then 10 minutes later, he was home. Actually, no, it was more like 15 minutes and he was home. Yeah, and then anyways, he went and got her. I haven't taken a bath, just me, in at least, it's been less than a year, because I think I did it once here, but, or maybe twice, tops, but, oh my god, guys, like, there was one point where I was so relaxed, and it kind of frightened me, because I haven't been relaxed in a long while, really. Anyway, so my heart started like beating really fast and weird, and I was like, what the hell? That could also be my weight or anxiety and such, I don't know. But anyway, after that I started to like doze off, and then I was like, holy crap, like I woke up. Well, I wasn't sleeping, but like, I don't know what like made me not fall asleep, but my heart was like going fast again, and I'm like, what the hell? Anyway, so it was just really nice. I put a watermelon bubble bath in it, Epsom salts, and a little bit of eucalyptus oil. Plus, I had 3 candles going, and they smelled delicious. And turned the heat on and stuff, because we, like, I think I already mentioned that we don't turn the heat on in the basement bathroom. Oh, don't mind me. I'm so tongue-tied or whatever, just tired. That felt amazing. I pretty much almost stayed in there between 1.5 hours and 2 hours. And then I went for a walk, which was 25 to 30 minutes. And that felt amazing. Like, really good. I came home and ended up eating crap. So, whatever. It is what it is. I had 2 macaroni Michelinas and 2 fudgesicles, a few Jolly Rancher hard candy, and a few taco bites. So that was like my supper and snack. And then Matt and I hung out, watched The New Girl, a couple of episodes, and I was editing a little bit before that. I cleaned up the play yard, emptied the dishwasher, filled it, gave the cats their food. And now here I am actually watching this YouTube channel called SciShow. And this one's about GMOs. And this has always been my gut feeling about GMOs. And I feel like people are just kind of like jumping on the bandwagon to say, let's get rid of them. But when you really think about it, we're going to end up with a food shortage. Because I think the only way we've been able to sustain this is the fact that we have GMOs. So if we all want to die of famine and sickness and whatever, this is a really good way to do it. So I think that, in my opinion, I'm not a scientist and such, but I feel like people are jumping the gun on this, and once they're illegal, we're going to be screwed. So anyway, here's a little clip of this video.
In general, I think we played our cards too close to our chest when it comes to how we really feel about genetic engineering here at SciShow. So why are GMOs bad? They're not. They just aren't, not intrinsically, and certainly not for your health. We've been eating them for decades with no ill effects, which makes sense because a genetically modified organism is simply an organism like any other organism that produces tens of thousands of proteins, but one or two of them were proteins that were chosen specifically by us humans. Genetic engineering is necessary for the continued success of the human experiment here on planet Earth. Just like the advent of nitrogen fixing allowed for more fertile fields that saved millions from starvation, the fruits of genetic engineering, sometimes literally, will help us face the significant challenges of a world with more and more people and a climate that is less and less stable. Of course, just like nitrogen fixing allowed Germany to build bigger bombs, genetic engineering is a tool that can be used for good or for evil. So yes, it must be studied and controlled and understood, but that understanding has to start with, like, us. Right now.
I don't know about you, but my thoughts on that have been quite similar to what they said, and I'd love to hear what some of you guys think about the whole GMO thing. I imagine there's going to be a response of, oh, GMOs are super bad, but we're some of the longest living humans in the history of the world, of the Earth, and of course, there are some tribes that live long, long into their 100 years. I'd say we're pretty fortunate, except those who get cancer. But maybe cancer has always existed and that's what took people so young before. Maybe, I don't know. Anyway, just tell me what you think because I can't ramble on. This video's already long. Yeah, I'm just watching that, and once this video's done, it's a pretty good channel. I think I'm addicted. I subscribed. Then I'm going to edit the video from the 18th of January and then go to bed. So anyway, that was my day today. I'm hoping for a fully good day tomorrow. So I am going to close up the vlog for tonight. Good night, everyone.
Whoa, honey. You're doing really good. Come on.
How can it?
Hi, Liam. There.
She's like, it's a little uneven here. I'm going to take a break. Wow. What is Aiden doing, Liam? Is he swinging? The sun. Honey, come here. Come on. Come see Mom. Yeah, I was like, it's not cold enough to put her little scarf thing on, but I was like, I'm going to put the other stuff on.
Just I didn't in case. Put snow pants on, but I put like splash pants.
Yeah, I never even thought. I just bought splash pants for her too. You were walking all over the place before I started the video. Go ahead. There. Now that you're over that little hump, you should be okay. Want me to let go now? Want me to let go?
Liam, where are you going?
No, not good job, Honesty. It's because there's no snow, huh? Oh, there you go. Yeah. That's what I'm waiting for. Woohoo! That's so much fun.
Yeah.
It's been a while, huh, that you've been on the swing. Oh. And there's Liam. Whoa! Little monkey. Your little monkey.
No. Oh, I think it's this.
Woohoo! There.
Hey guys, it is 11:50 and it is February 3rd. And that means Honesty turned 17 months today. It's 11:50 p.m., not a.m. I have not vlogged at all today until now. I just really haven't been feeling like vlogging much because getting caught up is like consuming me, and then I get frustrated because I can't seem to find the time to get caught up, so then I end up not even editing here and there. I had 10 gigs to go through in the video for January 19th, so yeah, it was a lot of footage. I'm cuddling with Mr. Bootsy Pie right now. He's so cute. Oh boy, you can kind of see his ear there in the corner over here, right there. What a cutie. Oh, there's his whiskers. Had a so-so day today. I'm having a hard time being a mom lately. I feel like I can never get anything done that I need to get done, but I decided that every day I would do something emotionally for me that would help me evolve emotionally. Today, the thing I did was when Honesty broke a plate, one of our plates, she basically was trying to get the food off the plate and down to the floor it went and broke. First thing I thought is, oh my god, I hope that didn't get on her. So I looked around and there's no ceramic on her, but there's like ceramic in other places. So I cleaned that up immediately. But when she dropped it, I was already having issues with her using her spoon. Like, she refuses to just use the spoon for eating. She'll eat, but the problem is that she plays with it a lot, so it gets a little frustrating. So I ended up crying, and normally I would just get angry, get upset, and yell at her lately for something that, you know, important, like she could have gotten hurt. It was my fault for letting her even use a ceramic plate. It's just she never throws her plates or bowls on the floor. Of course, when they're plastic, and then I give her one that is ceramic, and boom, on the floor it goes. Super frustrating, but she'll get there in time. And so I gave myself the gift of self-control. And crying has always been a great release for me. And so I didn't like cry out loud. I just cried silently. Just let it roll. And it helped, like, amazingly. Because before that I had raised my voice to her about not using the spoon. Now the newest thing she started doing tonight was bending the spoon. This girl's too smart for her own good sometimes. So I guess that's what you get with a 17-month-old when they're like in the terrible twos before two. Other than that, she's doing really good. She says even more words like foot, fall, floor, fart. I think I already said she says snack, knack. It was a pretty lax day. She played, then chilled and watched cartoons, and then I played with her. And then I fed her lunch, she went down for her nap, and then I just seriously like read a bunch of articles online and just relaxed. That's a good thing I did for me emotionally. Normally I'd just stress and like force myself into working on the vlogs when I didn't feel like it at the time. Don't get me wrong, I love editing vlogs and stuff and like watching them over and whatever. But when, you know, I've been taking care of her all morning and then I need a break just to unwind, and then next thing you know, the hour and a half to 2.5 hours flies by so fast if I've got other things to do, like
cooker stuff or prepare things, like, it ends up being gone. So, anyways, it was nice. Tonight, I cleaned up the play yard, obviously, and I filled the dishwasher. We did not fill it completely today, so I have no reason to start it. I'll probably have to start it after breakfast or after lunch tomorrow. And then I did a wash the bath mat because, unfortunately, this little guy here, Boots, he threw up on the mat. And then he threw up in his litter box. He's struggling, and I keep telling Matt we gotta take him to the vet. And he's like, oh, well, there's not really much they can do, but I'm gonna be really adamant. Hopefully he'll go for that. If anything at all, we just need to get his blood and urine tested to make sure he's doing good and get him weighed, because I'm pretty sure he's gaining, which is a good thing. So, for the most part. Because cats with renal failure tend to lose their appetite. So if he's not losing his appetite, it's a good thing. He lost his appetite for the wet food, but the wet food we give him, but he eats paws food. Plus he'll eat his dry food and then her dry food sometimes. So, I mean, he's eating and, he seems to be getting some water, so that's a good thing. Honesty is also growing her molar, the left-hand lower side molar. Woohoo! So I knew I was right that the reason why she's been waking and fussing a little extra is because she's teething. I was supposed to do a challenge with my friend Angie. She's got a channel called, I think, Angie's Life or Angie's World, and a couple other channels actually too. I'll put her channel in the description below. Her and I were supposed to do a challenge for healthy eating, and once she recuperated from the accident she was in, then we would work out. But for now, she can only do like 10 minutes of walking. But we're both doing what we can. I've been mostly eating pretty good during the day. I know you guys haven't been seeing what I've been eating, but then my problem is supper and nighttime. So I'm working on that. I've got two meals down, and that is a feat in itself. So anyway, I was going to do that with her, but then I had a huge anxiety attack on February 1st, which is when we were supposed to start. Oh, hey, buddy. Aww. He likes to prop his head up against things. It's so cute. Aww. She was understanding. I can't do it right now. I can't even do it for myself. So if I'm going to do some sort of weight loss, I'm not gonna do it with anybody, and I'm not gonna do it for anybody. Well, maybe with Matt or something, but we don't even always eat the same thing, so technically it still wouldn't be with him. I have been walking. I've walked 3 times already. I took an amazing 1.5 to 2 hour bubble bath with watermelon bubble bath, eucalyptus oil, and Epsom salts, and then in the candlelight, and it was so amazing. That's one thing I've done for myself emotionally. And I turned on some meditation music for most of that, or chakra clearing is what it is. And I absolutely loved it. So anyways, that's basically my update. Today wasn't, nothing big happened. I showered, bathed Honesty. Trying to think if there's anything else. No, that's about it. I've been kind of having an off day at times, but at other times it was good. So anyway, I'm just going through lots of ups and downs right now, and I'm working through them the best I can, being deactivated from Facebook. So anyways, I'm going to close up the vlog for tonight. Good night, everyone. Hey guys, so it's 11:45, and Matt went to bed not too long ago, 11 o'clock or whatever, something like that. And
I figured I would get a vlog in. I've been watching a YouTube channel from her YouTube channel is High Carb Hannah, and I'm feeling kind of inspired. Lately, she's been doing something called the potato diet, and it's kind of intriguing me because I've always been drawn to potatoes, high carb foods like bananas and such, and I think it would work for me. Like, I did the raw vegan thing and then I did the vegan thing, but this seems different. And she's like a big believer in listening to yourself intuitively and instead of saying like, do it this way, it's so cut and dry, if you don't do it this way you're gonna gain weight or whatever. So I am definitely looking into it. I have a friend here who follows me on YouTube and has supported me for quite a few years now. His channel is Rubber Wilbur and his name is Brandon, and he pointed me in the direction of the McDougal way, which is the starch solution, and she believes in the starch solution wholeheartedly because she decided to try the whole raw till 4 thing and was basically doing 20 bananas, or no, like she'd do 10 bananas in the morning and then have Gatorade. If any of you guys have done the vegan diet, you know what that stuff is. If you know who Freely or Durian Ryder are, you'll know that. Gatorade is like a whole bunch of dates with like water or coconut water, basically. Actually, I think it is coconut water, and it's the coconut water, instead of it being Gatorade, which replenishes your electrolytes, coconut water replenishes your electrolytes in a healthier fashion. And then she would have a really high carb supper, like 1,000 calories of rice, or like a bunch of potatoes or something to the sort. And it was vegan. So, something's been calling me to go back to this. I actually got Matt to get us takeout today. I wanted Arby's because Kim was talking about it the other day. And well, I keep having those on and off moments. And as one of my subscribers, new subscribers, has said, just basically eat like your daughter. You're feeding her in a great way. And so, you know, that kind of hit me because I was like, yeah, I should be. It will eventually partially help you with these depressed feelings and emotions. And I know she's right for the most part. But even when I went raw, after like 5 months, the stress was already starting to seep in. And then by month 10, I was a mess. And I was ready to quit. I went and ate Burger King and I was like, oh, I'll just do it once. And I've pretty much been on and off raw or vegan for like 6 years now almost. So I gotta get my act together. Eating well, getting my thoughts on track, trying to, you know, not just convince myself, but feel better wholeheartedly. Because I don't want to do none of that mumbo jumbo, fake it till you make it. I don't believe in that. Total disconnect within your body. I don't care if you believe that or not. You're telling your mind one thing, but your body is elsewhere. So yes, I believe in having goals and striving for those goals, but also living in the moment. And not striving too much, like not obsessing over them. And I feel that in doing that, it's gonna like quell some of the anxiety and quell the depression. And I don't know. I'm gonna talk to Matt tomorrow, see what he thinks, whether he wants to do the whole vegan thing with me or not. He might, but he's always talking about how he wants our grocery bill to be less expensive. Yeah, like rice, sweet potato, regular potato, some pasta. It's not even gonna be that expensive. And the thing is, Hannah, she even says adding sodium to your meals is absolutely fine because you're not eating a bunch of processed junk in which they use, you know, just normal table salt, everyday table salt. We can make the conscious effort to use sea salt or Himalayan crystal salt, whatever we choose. And then we're still getting sodium because sodium, you need sodium in your body. And you don't even have to add a lot. It just depends on what your flavor palette is. The thing is, these vegetables have sodium naturally occurring in them as well. So that's really good. When I was younger, I would have a mound of potatoes or mashed potatoes and mashed carrot and just like go crazy on it, or like eat 5-6 bananas in a row. And you know, I thought I was doing something wrong, but it turns out I really wasn't, because I stayed thin and I had a lot of energy back then. Like a lot. I was super bubbly. My depression didn't even start to hit me until I started restricting like carbs like that, like potatoes and bananas sometimes. Like it just, so I don't know. I'm gonna give it a shot, I think. I got Matt to pick up some stuff from the grocery store. We've got like quinoa pasta, eggplant, which I want to try, but I also want Honesty to try because she hasn't tried that yet. I think I've tried eggplant once or twice so far, and it was okay both times I tried it. So even though I don't really love it, I still want her to try things so that she can make good decisions later on what she likes. We got leeks, eggplant, I got a bunch of zucchini because I'd like to make some sort of like stir fry with like carrots, zucchini, and whatever, maybe the quinoa pasta or something, but an onion, so it should be pretty delicious. Maybe some broccoli in there. We're supposed to get a storm tomorrow. Yay! Kim and I are gonna have to cancel again. Ask me how excited I am about that. Not. Obviously, we can't control the weather, but seriously, Mother Nature, stop screwing with our Fridays. We want to hang out. If we didn't have plans Saturday and Sunday, I would totally reschedule with her for one of those days, and I imagine she has plans too, though. So, anyway, here's to hoping next Friday goes well, or that it doesn't snow at all tomorrow. That would be amazing. Today went really well. Honesty ate her oatmeal quite well. She didn't eat her lunch quite as well, or her supper, but she still ate some. And like, we gave her praise, but I think we were a little too crazy. I don't know if that makes any sense, but we were like, yay, woohoo, and clapping and making a great big deal out of it. And I don't want to give her a big head or make her think that, you know, everybody in the world is always going to give her that approval. So I think that we're going to tone it down. We're still going to say good job, but we're just going to like, yeah, good job, honey. But now we've set the bar so high, I don't know if a good job, honey, is going to be enough. Like, she's gonna want us to clap and go, woohoo, yeah. You know, so, the things you learn. I was really tired today, though. That lymph node's getting a bit bigger. I've been having some pain in my pelvis on the right and left side. My hip is still hurting. Matt keeps saying, call the doctor. I keep saying, yeah, I would, but he never listens to me. I'm kind of at a crossroads. Do I just not go see him and continue to have all these issues, potentially getting rid of the issues by eating better and losing weight? Or do I go see him and potentially have him tell me that I'm going nuts and there's nothing wrong with me? He never said that. I don't want to put that out there, but he like basically said, you know, like your test results show nothing except for one thing, like, I don't know, probably a year ago now, but one of the tests showed that one of my liver enzymes was high. So that is indicative of fatty liver or fatty liver disease. So yeah, I need to get on this, get healthy, feel better, and just heal myself instead of looking for a psychiatrist to help heal me. I mean, it's always good to ask for help, but I know I can do this. I can do this. I want to do this for my little girl, because even the thought of waking up and then Matt, like, one of my fears is like waking up, Matt being at work, and something happens to me physically, like I have a heart attack or something happens and I can't take care of Honesty. That is like the saddest, scariest feeling ever, and I don't want, it's gonna happen someday that she's gonna be motherless, but I'd rather not it be today or tomorrow or anytime soon. So I gotta get on this. Anyway, I'm gonna close up the vlog for now because I'm rambling. Good night, everyone. Hey guys, it's 11:51, and yeah, don't mind the hair. Looks like crap. I haven't vlogged yet today. Like I told you, I'm just doing these one clippers. I've been trying to keep them short, but for the last couple days, they've been long. Today was a good day, although Honesty got really cranky near like the last hour and a half before she went to bed, because she's teething. Like I told you guys, she's got one of her molars that came out. So I think she's moving on to like the next molar or some things. It's just, she was cranky, like up here and then even downstairs. Like she would be having fun and then all of a sudden just start bawling. Don't mind, you probably hear this really loud rumbling. It's storming outside and there are plows going by. I was making a veggie stir fry with leeks, zucchini, carrots, onions, celery, broccoli. I think that's it. And then I made a ginger, honey, and soy sauce and made that. And of course, I suck at making friggin' stir fries. I end up adding softer vegetables first when carrots should have been the first ones in there, and then go from there once those were soft. But anyway, so it's pretty mushy stir fry, but whatever, it'll still taste good. I made some stuff for her, like white fish. Matt doesn't like white fish. I don't mind it, but there's not really much left and I want to save it for her. And then I made some organic quinoa corn pasta, penne pasta, and oh my god, it's so delicious. Like, it's really good. Like, wow. I would not have guessed that with how bitter quinoa can taste sometimes. Anyway, so I put a bit of ragu, some butter, and some shredded cheese in there and just stirred it up, and we have a small portion for Matt and I, and I believe my mom's coming over sometime before lunch tomorrow, so for her as well. And then Honesty has some for a few days. And then I also made her eggplant. I've only tried eggplant once or twice in my entire life, and I think I liked it one time but not the other. So I was like, well, maybe she'll like it, maybe she won't. So I got Matt to pick one up. It tasted okay. What I did is I baked it and I made some slits in it, kept the skin on while I was baking it, and I made slits in it and I shoved some Parmesan cheese in it. Once it was done, I added more parm to it and then stuck it in my little mini food processor and basically turned it into puree. I mean, I could have kept it like that, but I think if I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna steam it and it'll get more tender. We'll see how she likes it. I thought it was okay. I think she's gonna like it, knowing what she's liked before, and she's not very fussy. And that's what I made. It doesn't seem like a lot, but it certainly took a while, especially all the chopping of the veggies and stuff. We like to prep our meals ahead of time, and we're trying to eat healthier, so that really works. A lot of people have asked me how I make my intros and stuff. I make my intros with a program, but it's a website called Animoto.com, and I used to be subscribed to it, and then I just couldn't afford it anymore. Matt, for my birthday, I told him they were having a sale and it'd be awesome if I could get it. So I asked him and he said, yeah, sure. So I have a subscription to it. I had a 15% off code, so we saved like quite a bit of money, and it's awesome. So now I can make intros whenever I want, however many I want, and it'll be great. What I use it for is my intros and outros, but you can make a whole video on there, really. I'm just not really interested in doing that. I'll make my own video and then add an intro or outro. My birthday, yeah, that's coming up February 16th, actually. I am turning the big 3-0. Even though I look like I'm turning older than that. I'm not like, oh my god, I'm getting old or anything like that. It doesn't really bother me. But I'm just so grateful that I get to spend it with my husband and my daughter. And that's all that matters to me. And my friends, the ones that care enough to be there. So I'm going to close up the vlog for tonight. Good night, everyone. Hey guys, so it is almost 12 o'clock. And I am like so exhausted, but I don't want to go to bed because I have to edit a video and I want to watch a documentary and I'm just like, what? Because I only got 4 hours of sleep last night and today was a semi-okay day. Not even fully okay. For the first half of the day, I was tired, cranky, short with Matt. Then he left to go pick up my mom because my mom came over for this afternoon. And we were making slow cooker lasagna. So anyway, he started with cooking the ground beef and onions. And then I added in the pasta sauce and extra spices and such to the pasta sauce. And then next you know, it was time for Honesty's supper. So I was feeling overwhelmed because I couldn't get the lasagna prepped anymore. We were gonna have my mom and stepdad over for supper, so I had to hurry up and get that stuff made, but I couldn't. And Honesty, I was feeling super overwhelmed because Honesty kept screeching. She likes to put her little material box that we put our toys in, it collapses or whatever, and then you just put a rectangle piece in it so that it stays in the shape of a box, and then you put toys in it. It's just an organizational thing. You guys have seen them. Anyways, she took all the toys out and then put it on her head and was walking around the play yard. So I had to take them away, which I try not to do because she should be able to get her feelings out. I just need to teach her an easier way to get those feelings out. But I have to learn myself because when she was screeching too much, I eventually raised my voice at her. I went over into the dining room where she can't see me and I found out a technique instead of screaming at her, so I didn't want to scream at her again, to go somewhere where your child cannot see you and silently scream or scream into a pillow. I didn't have a pillow handy. And then of course I started bawling and I was a mess at that point. I called Matt. I said, I need you to hurry up and get home. It's too much pressure. I can't get the lasagna done. This is my fault, apparently. And I was just, couldn't believe it. And then of course, doesn't he get home with my mom after getting a few things that we needed? And he's all like pissy at me and he's like, I can't have a wife who's having meltdowns all the time. And I'm like, I can't help it. I want to get better, Matthew. Hence why I'm trying to do things for myself and trying to keep my cool, and I'm on a wait list for a psychiatrist. Like, you're supposed to be with me for sickness and in health, and here you are telling me that if my mental illness persists, you're going to leave me or something. Like, of course, so I'm already bawling. Of course, that makes me bawl more. Who says that? And he wonders why I can't get better. I need his support. I need his love. I need his understanding. I don't seem to get that from him. He just takes everything I'm saying personally, turns it around on me, and then makes me feel bad for feeling how I feel, which a lot of the time I don't really have control over. And it bothers me that he thinks if I could wake up in the morning and be super positive, have lots of energy, that I wouldn't do it. Maybe there's a roadblock there, but I don't see it. I don't understand why I don't feel the way I did when I was eating raw foods, or when I was in 2007. You know, I don't know. I don't know what the correlation is. I felt good and I felt happy and I felt genuinely positive in those times in my life, and confident even for the most part. And then something stressful came along and dragged me down. So now it's gotten to the point where when she screams like that and stuff, and I'm like right there in the next room, and I see that she's frustrated because maybe she wants to say something and express herself, but she can't say anything, or she can't do something the right way. But in some situations she's not in either of those. She just starts getting really upset and angry. So I don't know what to think, and I don't know how to make it better for her. I try to go up to her. I try to talk softly to her. I try to hug her. I kiss her. Sometimes it doesn't calm her down. She has like full-out tantrums where she's like banging her head or biting her hand, and it scares me. Like, I know her screaming and crying and stuff came before me even raising my voice to her. But, like, am I adding to that anger, to that frustration with her? And all I know is that I have to make the situation better. So come Monday, I am calling my doctor. I don't give a crap. He's going to have to listen to me. And that's it. We are going to get me to a psychologist as soon as possible. He's going to do tests like he has to. He is getting paid to make sure me, the client, is healthy, and I'm having health issues. My hip hurts. I'm 29 years old. I'm going to be 30 in a matter of days, actually 9 days to be specific. Doesn't add up. I'm gaining all this weight as I eat crap, but there are times where I eat okay. And why, I have binge eating disorder, but I don't get it. There are times where I've tried to eat pretty well lately since the pregnancy, and like seems like nothing comes off, or at least not as quickly as I would like whenever I'd start a weight loss thing. And yes, I know I'm getting older, yada yada yada, and I had a baby, my whole system has changed, but when I used to lose weight before, I would lose so much so easily. Even in the beginning, like, I'd start a program and then within a week I'd lose like 10 pounds, and I know most of that's water weight, but I don't even get that now. I'm lucky if I lose 3 pounds. Like, my body is just holding on to water. And I don't crave water, and I don't want water most of the time. I don't drink that much. Like, I'm lucky if I get a Starbucks in once a day and maybe a glass of water. Like, well, 2 glasses because it's a mason jar full or whatever. But it just doesn't make sense. Why would I drink when I'm not thirsty? And then when I do try and drink, when I feel like dry in the mouth, makes it worse. Anyways, I'm just rambling, and I know you guys are accustomed to the daily vlogs where I go around and I'm doing all my day and stuff like that. I'm gonna get back to that once I get caught up, if ever. I don't know, guys. Maybe I never will get caught up, and that bothers me, but at the same time, I want to do other things, and I want to live my life, and I want to get better, and I want to have the energy and time to spend with my daughter and do the things I need to do around the house and spend time with friends and family. And
did the things I normally do, fed the cats, filled the dishwasher, cleaned the play yard. I still have laundry I have to fold. I started folding some the other day and then got distracted because Matt and I started watching The New Girl, and then I was too tired, and then I had to edit anyways, so... Oh boy, one of these days I'll get caught up on laundry, or we need to win the lottery. We're coming to a windfall of money so we can hire someone to do it. Because I despise laundry. I just do. I always have. I can do the other things. I clean, you know, the bathrooms. I clean the kitchen. I, you know, tidy up other stuff or whatever. And I can do the litter box when Matt's not doing it. I can wash and dry the laundry, but for some reason when it comes to folding it, putting it away, it sits in our living room for a few days or in the laundry room, just like sitting in there on the washer or dryer. I'm feeling pretty lethargic. Last night I watched a movie. I rarely get to watch movies, and I'm watching a documentary. I love documentaries. It's a National Geographic documentary, but I never get to because I'm always editing or I'm always doing something, chores, spending time with Honesty, spending time with Matt, family, friends, whatever. That's okay. And then being distracted by Facebook at times too, which is super annoying, which is why I'm on a break right now. But anyway, so there I go rambling again. I am going to close up the vlog for tonight. Good night, everyone. Hey guys, it is 1:59 of the next day, February 8th. Yesterday was February 7th, and I didn't vlog. Gosh dang it. I haven't been taking the camera out much. Like I said, I've been only doing this one clip at night. I don't always want it to be this way. I also said that. And I want to get caught up, but especially on weekends, most of the time, since Matt's taking care of Honesty, I just want to relax. I'm sick of, and I'm about to swear, busting my ass to get the vlogs done. And, you know, I appreciate the people who come around and watch them regularly and such. But I'm on a Facebook break right now, and what I find quite annoying is that nobody reaches out past Facebook saying, oh my gosh, are you okay? Where have you been? Most people know I make YouTube videos. Most people could search me and find me, I'm sure, on YouTube. But they choose not to because they don't care. So I have a lot of fake relations on Facebook, clearly. Clearly these people would have reached out if they wanted to keep in contact. So I have been actually thinking of either deleting Facebook or deleting everyone that isn't a close family member, a close friend, or at least an acquaintance that is near and dear to my heart, and I am to them. So if you're not in that category, what I would do at that point is say, okay, I'm going to point you all to my page. You can see what's up with me. Since you don't want to interact, this is probably the better option for you rather than just kind of sitting on my list. You know, it just kind of clogs up my... I don't want to be rude, but there's people that add me that, you know, I'm like, okay, I'm not sure why they added me. Maybe they just want extra people. Maybe they were I was suggested to them. I don't know what the reasoning is, but they don't talk to me, and I don't have the time or energy to talk to all these people who add me. And I've added some people when I thought I was going to have time and energy to talk to a bunch of people, but I just didn't. So now when these suggestions come up, do you know this person? Unless I know them, in my direct reality, I don't have them. And people who try and add me that have mutual friends now, I don't even usually accept those. Like, sometimes I will. It just depends. There has to be, like, I don't know, maybe 100, couple hundred or more mutual friends. But even that now, I'm just like, man, like, some people seem to be adding me because I used to be big into the raw thing and the vegan thing. And I still have quite an interest in that. And I hope to be picking something up like that, you know, in the next little while again.
but it's not my main focus and I don't want anyone to think that. Or just deleting Facebook altogether and start using text and still use Twitter and Pinterest and YouTube. And today was actually a pretty good day for the most part. Honesty's been a little cranky though and a little off and frustrated because she is teething and she wakes up every now and again and sometimes wakes up for a couple hours and just babbles and like, oh, it's so sad. I can't wait until all her teeth are out so she can feel good and feel happy because that's the kind of little girl she is. She's a very happy, very fun little girl. So not only do I hope for that for her, but for us, because the screeching that she's been doing in the last little while and the biting of her hand, it's been getting to us, both of us. And the last thing I want is to feel disconnected with my daughter. I would love for her to feel better soon. And other than that, she ate pretty well today. No fussiness. Yesterday she was pretty fussy though. She had French toast for breakfast, Matt said, and some fruit and yogurt. And then for lunch she had turnip, eggplant mixed with lentils, and a toast with butter and some milk, I believe. For snack she had a little bit of puffs but didn't really eat them all, so we never bothered with the cheese. And then for supper we went out as a family to eat supper at a restaurant called the Silver Fox, and it was delicious. Matt got a fried clam plate with fries and coleslaw and some special sauce or whatever. And I got a lobster roll with some fries and some coleslaw. And we got Honesty a roast beef dinner. And so it came with roast beef, mashed potatoes, carrots, and peas. And we got her some milk. And she loved it. She was getting a little bit slow and fussy on the beef, so we put a little bit of ketchup on it and away it went. So yeah, and she had half a banana and some cookie while we were waiting for the food to get there. I know we did it a little backwards, but hey, whatever. She was playing with the crayons and like, you know, drawing some lines on the piece of paper with the little children's activities on it. But then she'd start eating the crayons. That's the thing. Every time I bring out the crayons, she does it. And she does it because it makes us upset. That's the thing toddlers do sometimes. Like, we'll be like, no, Honesty. Ah, gross. Yuck. And she'll just smile and keep doing it. And, like, she's got this new thing where her temper, like, she shakes. Ugh, I don't know. Yesterday, I'm pretty sure I was having a migraine because when I looked at Honesty's sleeper, the pattern on her sleeper was like leopard, pink leopard, gray, white, whatever. And it was all like vibrating. It looked like it was vibrating. But that's the only thing that was doing that. And of course I see like floaters and stuff. So, scary stuff. I don't know if it's because I'm not getting enough sleep or what, but, and drinking coffee, I gotta cut that too. Matt and I have been looking into something called the potato diet. I'll talk about that more as it gets closer, but we're going to eat all the food we have now, and then after it's all gone, we'll start up this new way of eating, and I'll talk about it then. Honesty enjoyed her supper. We enjoyed her supper. We came home. We all spent time together for an hour before she had to go to bed. It was very enjoyable, so we had a great night. I told Matt, like, I find we don't spend time as a family as much because both him and I are so focused on whose turn is it to take care of her, you know? Is it yours or is it mine? Instead of being like, let's both spend time together and with Honesty. So now we're making it a point that every Sunday, unless there's like a family thing that's going on, Sunday at supper or around there, we'll go do something. Like either go for a walk together or go to the zoo. Right now I don't think it's open, but, or go out and eat or whatever, something. And that's what we did tonight, and I loved it. I think Matt loved it as well, and Honesty, well, she was, you know, pretty good, so I'm guessing she liked it. I got a little burst of energy tonight and danced around a little bit, so that was nice. I haven't had the energy or the desire to dance much, if at all, for a long while, so that felt really good. What also feels really good is that both my cats, Paws, she's been sitting on my leg for like every couple of days. She'll come sit on my leg. It's so odd and so amazing. I miss it. And then Boots has been laying with me too, so I love that lots. Anyway, so that's how my day went. I'm gonna close up the vlog for tonight. Good night, everyone. Hey guys, it's 12:40 and I totally forgot to vlog before midnight. I was going to, but I was editing the vlog that I did for basically a whole week so that I could get caught up. And then I'm gonna do another one of those tomorrow. Today was actually a really good day. Honesty woke up in the middle of the night at some point and stayed up for a couple of hours, but then she stayed asleep until I think it was like close to 9 o'clock, like maybe 10 to 9, and I got her breakfast ready, which consisted of cereal, yogurt, crushed raspberries, banana, and water. And then she played, and then her and I cuddled and watched some cartoons, and then we played a bit, and then it was her lunchtime, so I made her her lunch, and her lunch consisted of dill buttered haddock that I made up for her, and some squash and sweet potato, plus she had some pasta with pasta sauce, butter, cheese, and then she had some water to drink, and she had a cheese string because she wasn't hungry for a snack. I usually only give her a snack when I know she starts fussing and she wants one, so she didn't do that this morning. I was like, oh my god, progress. Like, she's teething a lot, guys, big time. Like, the four canines are on their way out. She just got one of her molars. Pretty sure the other ones are on their way out too. She's getting a lot all at once, so I can understand where the crankiness and such is coming from. And then she had half a banana, and then she went down for her nap, and she went down for a nap for almost 2 hours, got up, was still in a great mood. Her and I played once I brought her up here, and it was so fun. Matt got home, and then we heated up our supper. For supper, we had some lasagna, and Honesty also had some pineapple, a vanilla teething biscuit. I've been drinking more water. That's actually really good. For breakfast, I had sauerkraut, some stir fry that I made up, and a sausage. I'm having the weirdest craving for Tostitos, mac and cheese, Michelina, and sausage and cheese on top. I don't know why, like, it's basically nachos with macaroni, cheese, and sausage. I'm feeling absolutely amazing being almost caught up on the vlog. Ah, what a relief. So I get another 7 day one up tomorrow, and, or actually it's more like 8 days. I am gonna close up the vlog for tonight. Good night, everyone.